Good day, everyone. Welcome to another episode of
Mom and Son Podcast. This is Rose Fres Fausto, the mom, also known as FQ Mom.
And this is Anton Fausto, the son. I want to greet everybody a new month, a happy month.
Hopefully. A new quarter.
Oh, yeah, a new quarter.
Yes.
Hopefully a better one. This has been the toughest. This has been the toughest quarter. I have ever
I think we will have a tougher second quarter.
Oh my gosh.
I think. In terms of economy.
Yeah. But I hope no more, you know, I mean,
No more new things, you mean?
Yeah, no
so
more new things.
So that we can answer the current one.
We had an explosion.
Yes.
A volcano eruption. Eruption rather. Kobe died. And then the COVID-19. So... I'm praying that it's gonna get better. And with things getting better, it's actually medyo sakto kasi it's already Holy Week. And I'm sure
yes.
a lot of people didn't notice it. Didn't usually kasi parang you can kind of feel na Lent is the 40 days, you can really feel the length of it. But
yes.
then na bigla lang, oh, it's Holy Week na. I guess it's Holy Week time.
And actually, I saw this post that it's a long weekend.
Yeah.
Because it's Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Pero para bang, uh-oh, it's been a long week's end.
Yeah. Well, at least there's a distinction now. And I think it's important also for the people who work from home have that Monday to Friday
yes.
schedule to have the distinction na is it considered a holiday?
Yes, it is.
Holiday.
So, dapat, mga work from
holy
home.
Holy day. I think it's a holy
you
day
you treat
also.
Your Thursday, Friday, this week, differently.
Yeah.
For sanity. Na,
there probably is some work to do, but then since these are the... It's this time, the next few days are going to be allotted to our faith, and there's a reason behind the holiday. So, let us act accordingly.
Yep.
Anyway, so our message for today, the reason why it's a new Holy Week, our title for today's new Holy Week, is because inevitably... Everything's new. I mean, the way we do things is pretty much new. Wala na yung mga traditions natin. We can't do the processions. Actually, just a few days ago during Palm Sunday, what did our village do?
Oh, there's a priest who, in a vehicle, he also went to our villages. So if you signed up and you want your palms to be blessed, mm-hmm. he roamed around. So we had to get permits for this, etc. No more holy water. Basta binibless na lang niya with prayers.
Yeah. And it's connecting to our next point that you don't need to be touched by the holy water to be blessed. And just like the whole spirit behind the tradition, just because we can't physically do the traditions we've been so accustomed to doing, we're so used to doing, doesn't mean, you know, this Holy Week is gonna be any less holy or any less meaningful than the ones we had in the past.
That's true. And in fact, during the homily in last Palm Sunday's Mass, that was explained the externalities. Because that's what's easier for us to understand. We as humans, we need to touch, we need to feel, we need to hear, we need to see. But because of the times, we will now have to reinvent the way we observe the Holy Week. So, in fact, it's probably an opportune time to really get into the meaning of it. Kasi nga, hindi ka na magbibisita iglesia, sa labas.
Yeah, there are times na we can get lost in the traditions na we forget why we're doing it in the first place.
Totoo yan.
Parang, baka we can, for example, the visita iglesia, we might be too caught up with the, what churches am I gonna go to? What prayers are we gonna recite? Na parang, that's all you... Your main focus went to the logistics of it. For example, the plan on which church you're gonna go to, traffic, ganyan. Now we're forgetting na what we're
Why
going
are
there.
We doing
yeah,
that,
yeah.
It's really to reenact the passion.
Yeah, it's also to practice our faith, to worship. Now we can do those things. Now we're kind of forced to reinvent it and do it in another way. Because there was this. We heard Mass a few days ago online, of course, and there was a what do you say? Not a speech. There was a
which
a
one?
Study the one by Brother Audie.
Okay. That's the feast talk after the Mass.
Yeah. So finally, they talk about their personal experiences.
Yes. Related, they make it relevant.
Yeah, they talk about the scripture. And it is something, Brother Audie, shared a story that I actually have experienced a couple of times already.
Okay, tell us this story.
So, I love playing basketball. And I was never any varsity. I wasn't part of any varsity team or I never had training. But then, in Ateneo, we would always just play pickup basketball during breaks, during dismissal, with whoever.
Okay.
With whoever's free. And then there's one time, one of my org mates, I was in a dance org, so we're not basketball players. Ha? So, we were playing. One of the younger, he was a freshman payata. I was a senior. He was a freshman. He's a really, really tall guy. He's a okay. really big guy also. So, sobrang sakto talaga to the story of Brother Audie. And then I was thinking, oh my gosh, like I wanna get him on my team. One, he was super tall. Next, he had the headband, he had the wristband and the shooting sleeve.
Oh.
Yung shooting sleeve kasi, especially dito sa Pilipinas, no one wears that. Kasi yung shooting sleeve, you know what the shooting sleeve looks
yeah.
like? The one Kobe would always wear. Rest in peace. You don't need that in the Philippines kasi pagagi naman mainit, whatever court you play. And then I don't know what the point is.
Is that to make it warm ba?
I think so. Kasi okay. guess ko yung wristband or headband. Parang wipe the sweat, keep okay. the sweat out of your face. But then yung shooting sleeve, parang weird. So I was thinking, okay.
He must be really good.
He must be really good. And then, yung branded talaga yung lahat ng suit niya, hindi yung naka PE shorts, Ateneo PE t-shirt lang, ganun. As in, branded
jersey.
Talaga. So, okay, sige, game. Then when we started playing, sobrang banu pa nga niya. As in, the type of big, awkward person na it looked weird nga to see someone wearing those clothes play that poorly. And then, so relating back to Brother Audie's story, he said na, just because you have the gear.
The gear, kasi that player was so fully geared, na.
Yeah, it doesn't mean you have the game.
Wow.
And that's something
say
that
again,
really,
please.
That really stuck to me. Just because you have the gear doesn't mean you have the game. And if we relate it to the Holy Week, just because we've done all the traditions, let's say you've watched all the versions of Passion of Christ that's out there. You've gone to all the churches and prayed there. But if you don't live out, you know, the meaning of it, if you
of
don't...
Christianity.
Yeah, if you don't take it to heart.
Person, yes.
It doesn't really mean anything
parang
also.
Parang puro externalities lang.
Yeah, puro porma lang.
Oh, puro porma lang. Wala palang laman sa loob. Oh,
yeah.
Okay. So now that we are just home, and we are forced to do away with the externalities, then talagang mapipilitan tayo to go internal, to
yeah.
go into the meaning, to really ponder upon anong ba talaga ang importance nito, no?
I would say with a lot of things naman, we should change our perspective on this. Instead of thinking of it as a hassle na, oh man, like we have to do things differently. Ganun. Why don't you take it as a challenge? Why don't you take it as like a game then? Pwede. Na parang, okay, this is the situation. These are the parameters. Can't go outside of the house, whatever. How can we still achieve the goal of celebrating
yes.
and giving out the message of the Holy Week?
Oh, I have one suggestion pala. I've been doing this for a good number of years na rin. The online retreat.
Mm.
By Father Johnny Go. Search that out.
I remember you've been... how many years na you sent us the links?
Yeah, that one.
Then,
Pins of Light.
I honestly never got the chance.
Also
but
now,
the chance is here now. So
yeah.
We'll see. Maybe. Most likely I'm gonna do. And speaking of traditions, maybe we'd like to share our traditions. The
okay.
reason why the five of us, we're not really... I have a feeling other people are a lot more shocked and naninibago about Holy Week, we're gonna be at the
trip,
home.
No?
Yeah.
Kasi walang
trip.
Been,
walang trip. We've been experiencing Holy Week lockdown since the start. We never... There was only one time...
Two times lang.
Ever in our lives.
Two times ever.
We traveled during Holy Week.
Yeah,
and
because...
Not our thing.
And because of a reason that was the only time Enrique was available.
Mm.
And then there was another reason na we were already out and yung pabalik natin was parang Easter Sunday na yata eh.
Ah, okay.
Okay, so the story behind that is that both Papa and I, we grew up not going on out-of-town trips during the Holy Week. So, we would really observe.
So, it started then.
Yes. Yeah, so, parang, sa amin noon, bawal tatawa-tawa ka ng Holy Thursday and Friday. Bawal yun. Sasabihin nila, para kayong Hudyo. Tapos yung...
Which I, ano na, speaking of having new traditions, I remember that we weren't allowed, you didn't want us to listen to music when we were kids. But then, at least now, it's, at least now, medyo nag-chill na kayo.
Oo. Kasi, syempre, we cannot control you anymore, no? But the reminder lang is to just be more reflective during these days. Mindful. Kasi you also need that, eh. You need that recharge time, that reflection time. So anyway, that's when, bata pa kayo nun, eh, I remember. So I just decided, since we're home naman, make something productive out of it. And this was the time that we started culling our things. Sa closet niyo, that's where we started. Because when you were a lot younger and I would do the culling, naiinis kayo ko minsan because there are some shirts that you would still want to have. Pero tinanggal ko na pala kasi ang sikip-sikip na. So that's when I delegated that job to you. Okay, yeah. So
and
now
it, and it's our stuff, eh. So,
yes.
Siyempre, kami rin dapat yung mag-ayos noon on whether we're gonna keep it or not. So before there was Marie Kondo.
There was Marie Rose Kondo.
Yeah, we've been doing this from the very start. And I think that it was a very good idea to set it and connect it with the Holy Week. Kasi, aminin natin, culling is something that we've always had. I would say, I've always had this in the back of my head. If you see kagat, you're gonna think of, I'll clean those up. I'll fix that kagat when the day comes for me to fix that kagat. But we can't really, you wouldn't want to attach it to your birthday. Mm. You wouldn't want to attach it to Christmas. So far, oh, my birthday time to clean my stuff. Because for me, it's not that fun, syempre. It's a whole operation. It gets dusty.
Yeah.
It takes up time. And it's not just the physically doing it. It may emotional toll din yun. Yeah, that's right.
Especially for the sentimental things. Those that were given to you or those that remind you of something really important. Yeah. It's really very hard to get rid of them.
Sa akin yung mga costumes. But I made sure na there's a designated place there in my cabinet. So, yung mga dance costumes ko. Kasi, I know naman syempre, may mga dance costume kami na mukhang naka-leather basura bag. For example, But then, syempre, I don't want to throw that away kasi those are one of my favorite moments in high school. Mga ganun.
So, can you imagine if you've reached my age? So, ang dami-dami mo talagang ma-accumulate if you keep on doing that. That's why I also like the addition of yung mga principles ni Marie Kondo kasi ako rin mambubulok ako eh. And luckily, I could still fit in a lot of my old clothes, no? So, when she said that before you part with a certain piece of clothing or whatever, no? You have to thank it. That one really worked so well for me, ah. The first time we did that Marie Kondo thing. Kasi, hindi na ako nag-guilty na para bang you thank the service of that piece of whatever.
Yeah.
Very and then spiritual. You're able, oh, it is. And you're able to get rid of it without the guilt.
Yeah, and I think sakto na we do this activity during Holy Week. Because even if it's not a religious thing, the culling, I think there is a deeper
spirituality
experience.
To it, yeah, diba?
And since you're in that contemplative mood already, you're in that more solemn state where you remember things. Yeah, you think things through a little more. You kind of approach the things you do in a different different way. Now would be an opportune time to go through that. And I think it's not connecting to other things. It's not just the physical, not having that much clothes, the dust, the sentimental value. There's also an FQ part of it,
course.
Of course. Because there are those times I would admit I have this shirt. Or even, for example, it's not even in my closet. Let's say Kuya Marty or Dikong takes out a shirt na parang, oh, this is here, I've never seen. Parang, this isn't mine, ganun. That's happened na, oh, that's actually my shirt. But then, you wouldn't have seen that. Let's say you kind of forgot about that shirt na. I wouldn't go looking into their closets for that. Parang, yung mga things na you weren't really looking for, but then they turn up. And it can actually help you. Kasi, at least you know na, oh, I have these clothes pala. I'll probably it'll be longer pa before I have to buy new clothes.
That's why ako, I don't believe yung mga sasabihin nila, pero I know naman where my clothes are eh. I know, pero oh my gosh, ganun ka ba katalino? Computer ba yung mind mo? Ako hindi. In fact, there was a time in my life that I took pictures of all of them. Kasi all my shoes, my bags,
all, yung mga... How about the shirts din naman?
Yung shirt, medyo hindi masyado. Kasi, hinahang ko yung mga pang-alis.
Ah, okay.
So, yung pambahay yung naka-fold. Kasi, it's really hard. So, don't delude yourself in saying that, ay, hindi, I remember where my things are. Tapos, ang kalat-kalat mo. That, and, I'm sure that's not right. That's not true.
It'd be an easier, another way to look at it. It is, just make it easier for yourself. Like, yeah. Kasi, there are those times na, oh, I have to wear a red outfit for whatever event this is. Even if you probably, even if your past self probably knows where it is, why don't you just make it easier for yourself na even if you wake up, knock on wood, you wake up with amnesia, you can find, you can find a red piece of clothing, you can find this outfit that you need.
Oo. Tapos ako, I also, for those who are business-minded, maybe this is a tip that will work for you. You treat your closet like a prime property. So, di ba pag prime property, hindi kung ano-ano lang nilalagay mo dyan. Kasi that's what I also use when it comes to writing. You don't put so many things there. Parang you treat it, di ba? Especially now, napaka-iksi lang ng concentration span ng mga tao.
Yes.
So, same with reading. So, you have to treat that space as prime property. You only put what are important there. So, that's the same thing with your closet. Isipin mo, does this piece of clothing... deserve
to be in the prime property.
To be in the prime property.
And I think one last note for our episode. We said na it was an emotional experience also. Mm. And our family recently watched last week this movie that Kiyomarty was lots of his friends recommended to him. It's called Happy Old Year. For those with Netflix in the Philippines, you can see it. It's a Thai movie and it's about, without spoiling anything, it's about a girl who wants to clean up her house. Sobrang daming kagat na sa bahay nga. And she wants to throw them away. She wants to live a minimalist life.
Yeah.
But then, in the process of going through her old things, she sort of unravels and unearths a lot of emotional baggage as well. And I think it's a nice thing to watch in the... Especially now in the Holy Week, I would highly recommend it. For me, personally, it's a little slow. It's a little long. But the message is there. The message is really, it's really clear and it's really strong. Because getting rid of... Not getting rid. Cleaning up your stuff, your physical stuff, is in a way cleaning up your life also. And it's more holistic. Eh.
Parang nag-inventory ka, no? Okay, so we're looking forward. Are you looking forward to the culling?
A little.
Kasi it's also nice to rediscover your things, no?
Yeah. And I don't know how many shirts I have na, and how many years I've said, kakasya ako dito. We'll see, maybe this is the last time.
Have
that hope.
Pag meron kayong clothes na meron pang price tag, nako, pag-isip-isipan nyo na ha. Kung gano'n nakatagal, pag naka more than a year na yon, di nyo pa nagagamit. Medyo pag-isipan nyo na, is it something that you can sell or to give to someone? Kasi sayang yung space that it's occupying. And also, especially for the Christians out there, try to find something about the life of Christ to watch during this season with your family. And
it's nicer to we've connected to what we've been saying. Have another way, have another look at it. Maybe there's another movie. Maganda 'yan eh for us yung mga ibang perspective.
Ano na yung mga nagustuhan mo pala so we can share with them. Mga movies. Siyempre, Passion of Christ.
Passion of Christ is the OG. I wouldn't say I enjoy watching it. It's a must really watch, made but me then cry. Yeah. It's never a fun experience watching it. I like the one, I don't know the name, but it has Green Goblin.
Oh, is that the...
Green Goblin was Jesus.
Oh, what if Jesus got married? Yung mga ganun.
Yeah, what if Jesus had a normal life? Oh,
that's a very nice, thought-provoking.
Yeah, it's another...
Para siya. What if God was one of us?
That would be the one that stuck to me the most. Mga, even if it's not proven to be true, or even if our church doesn't say, you know, or they don't even promote it, for example. Yeah,
palaisipan.
I think it's nice to challenge. Challenge the faith, it makes it stronger.
Yeah, when you challenge your faith, you become more knowledgeable about it, diba? Mm-hmm. Tsaka mas hawak mo. You have a better grasp of it. How about the that thing that we watched, the Gospel According to Judas? Do you remember that?
Oh, that was, I was so young pa. National Geographic to, no? It was yung Gospel. I've always been curious about the story of Judas. Because we know the things about Peter, diba, John. Pero parang si Judas, tao rin naman siya. And yeah, he messed up. But then I would wanna know also, what's the story there? What is going through his head?
It's actually a very interesting story, yeah. Okay, Judas.
He just happened to be just
playing the role.
Everybody makes big mistakes. Everybody naman, they're at one time in their life, probably they have betrayed someone or something to some extent. He just happened to do it at the worst time. I mean, if you were to betray, that is the worst possible betraying you can ever do.
So if you're gonna compare the history of man, biblical characters, when it comes to timing, si Judas, parang ang bad timing niya.
Yeah, but the
tapos
thief,
yung isa,
the thief who was crucified beside Jesus.
Oh my God, yun yung talk about timing.
Clutch in this whole life. Na, oh, free pass to heaven.
Oh, by the way, I'm just reminded of something that I heard a Jesuit priest say. Di ko na maalala kung sino. It's possible that, di ba si Judas hung himself?
Mm-hmm.
But it's also possible that meron siyang nag-repent daw siya before he finally went.
Yeah, there's still that chance. And well, we can never can tell.
Until while you we're... die. So if you see him there.
Yeah, patanungin ko.
Okay. All right,
so thank you guys again. I hope you take this week really to rethink your practices and your traditions. And now more than ever, we do really need all the prayers we can get.
Oh yes. So magdasal po tayong lahat. This has been Rose Fresh Fausto, FQ Mom,
and Anton Fausto. Bye guys. Stay safe.
The Mom and Son podcast airs every Tuesday, 7 a.m. and can be streamed on Spotify, Apple iTunes, Google Podcasts, Buzzsprout.com, and YouTube. Just search Mom and Son podcast for your weekly dose of family, finance, passions, and everything in between. Leave a comment so other listeners may find this podcast. If you have any questions or suggested topics, email us at antonfausto@gmail.com.